Alright guys, this is Arthur right now, okay? Arthur, Indigo Punk, Indigo Soulja, there's a whole quadrant. But right now, this is just me, it's Arthur.
Right, okay.
And let me tell you something. Fuck you. Right. Fuck you for... Not you, you're cool, but fuck you, man. Like, for just undermining my creativity and questioning my word, you know, like, I don't know, I was just ranting about it earlier to myself when I figured actually I probably want this recorded, you know, because I don't know, I think someone, I really don't want to sue someone, but because that's really not how I roll. I really don't want to do that. But someone, sometime, when fucking answer to who the fuck has hacked into my computer comes up, I'm going to be very extremely tempted to sue the shit out of them. Yeah. My brother, he's a pretty good lawyer. You know what I mean? So let me turn this off. Okay, sorry. I need to go through the...
I'm gonna get this through. Doesn't matter what you do.
Okay.
I'm gonna speak the truth.
First of all, I'm not a fucking pedophile. Alright? I'm not a pedo. Just because I'm supportive to people in the community does not mean I fiddle with kids. Alright? That's fucked up. And just shut the fuck up, okay? Because that is actually really fucked up. Okay? Second of all, I'm not a fucking serial killer. Are you fucking crazy? A double negative reappearing by the hour. Fucking nuts. Okay. Serial killer. Like, can you imagine if I am a serial killer? Like, how much of a fucking, like, how? I'm gonna get this through. You know, I'm quite tempted to, like, get a suspicion that there's people buried in my garden so that, like, the police come dig up the garden and get the earth all, like, decompacted for us. You know, like... So, yeah, like, I buried, like, 20 babies in my garden. Like... Oh, and I've never knocked anyone up, okay? That's just never happened. Like, this is the most ridiculous thing I can conceive of. Like, I've kind of listened a bit to my music, and it's become apparent that maybe some of it sounds a little bit like I might have knocked someone up, and like there was being an abortion or something, and. No, never. Maybe, I think the song, my song Behind You, is maybe, it would make sense. And if you are actually someone who's been through an abortion and that song touches you and helps you get through it, that's fucking awesome. And I'm really happy that you can connect with it on that level and find that meaning in it. But for me, it's a song I wrote in 2012 about this crazy stalker girl in Sheppey who just won't let me go, who I was like, alright, fine, fuck it, it's 2012, let's turn over a new leaf, goodbye crazy stalker girl. I didn't call her crazy stalker girl at the time. I didn't even call her BMX girl at the time, I called her Misha. But basically I was like, alright, it's over, no worry. Like, she'd stopped talking to me for a long time for then, so I didn't actually send her the song, but it was like, it was more of a thing for me to just get over the hurdle. It's like, you know, scars on your back, like, that's more like it's more figurative, you know. If you ever wanna, you know, just like need some protection or whatever, or like if you ever wanna just just feel insecure or just like, or like cry or anything like that, you know. If you ever like, you know, I'm behind you, like, you know, I'm behind you, you know, like, but if you haven't, if those things are alive, yeah, I'll find you. I was actually originally going to write that about, I had a fucking concept album, like, which has a song called Wreck This Vessel in it as well, which I'm really happy with that song. Well, that, not the chorus so much, I think it's a little bit mental. And maybe, I'm starting to think, right, that when I recorded the vocals for that, it was probably quite audible to my neighbours. My neighbours could probably hear it. This was a couple of years ago. But, you know, I did a few takes on that, so maybe they just heard, like, a whole bunch of, like, crazy screaming coming from inside my house. And I thought that I was, like, murdering someone and burying them in my garden. That's pretty... I'm sorry, like, that... If you or anyone you know has been murdered, I'm sorry, I don't mean to offend you. I just find it extremely, like, you know, for me, death is a part of life. You know what I mean? It's just... And essentially, I think that love, well, the opposite, what's the opposite of love? The opposite of love is death, right? And what I've, because I've never had real love, you know, apart from, like, sort of love in my family, but it's always been a little bit distant, a little bit like, okay, here's a bit of money if you want, like, but, you know, we don't have much money, but here's some money, you know, now can you please love me? And I've never had a girlfriend, you know, I've never even had a girlfriend, let alone fucking knock someone up, you know. The best my best friend, she was actually probably was my best friend, like, over the last 2 years, like, lives in Raynham, and we're not talking anymore because she came over for the first time since I've known her, which is about 2-3 years maybe. She came over to our house. She's 17 now. She was what? She was like 14 when I met her. She said she was 15. We didn't get involved, you know. Like, I was just on my own in this world, pretty much. And I met her on the bus one day, and we got chatting because she was like, "Oh, how do I get to the skate place from here?" Or that. I was like, "Oh, it's basically over here. Yeah, yeah, yeah." And so, like, she asked me if she could add me on Facebook. I said, yeah, because you seem pretty cool. And then we just started talking since then. And we developed, like, a friendship, you know. Like, that's what happens. And she came over for the first time over summer. She's 17 now. And, like, I don't know, it just felt a little bit awkward. Because it's, like, she's been more of, like, my sister kind of thing. Like, these past years. And I kind of... I'm a little bit, I lose my rag a little bit sometimes, and I sent her quite a mean message. I said, oh fuck, I probably got it here. I blocked her again now, so thanks a lot, Facebook and shit. Alright, here we go. Yeah, okay, so now she's, like, now I swear someone's got to her because she's just, like, acting like a fucking idiot. Yeah, I don't know, they're probably gone. But, yeah, so, fuck you, man. I said, oh yeah, I sent her a message being like, because she came over, I was like, we're not going to have sex, Alex, I hope you know that. And then she was like, oh, and then she was like, oh, can you drive me home? I was like, well, okay. And then it was just, like, really awkward, and then I was like, you know what, just, like, just, I've had enough of you, because she's very up and down, Like, and so I was like, just talk, like, you know, get back in touch when you're 20 or something, you know, like, because you're a cool person, but you're just a bit mental. And so, yeah, wait, we need more tunes. And so, yeah, and then I think she got a little bit pissed off at it, and she said, ha 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 ha, all you have in your life is drugs and ugly girls. And which is not even true, because I don't even have any ugly girls. So, like, fuck you, Alex. Yeah, essentially, we want to listen to some Rakim now. So what else am I trying to clear my name off? Terrorist? Do you think I'm a terrorist? People, like, my family have been killed. Like, this is probably just a joke, but... First of all, I thought it was a joke. At first, people kept, like, asking me about my beard. Like, my beard, I was like... It's not like I've done anything. You can't compliment me on my beard. It's just fucking grown. It's just, that's what happens when you don't shave. This is what happens. This is what happens, Larry. Like, look. This is my fucking beard. I remember, like, keep talking about, like, ISIS and stuff, and just, like... Because I fucking love the Barbed Wire Dolls. And they lead singer is called ISIS Queen. Right? And she is pre-ISIS. She is pre-Islamic State. You know, this is... Like, you're a fucking idiot. You are retarded. You are so stupid. It blows my mind. As serious as cancer. Who can keep the average dancer hyper as a heart attack? Nobody smiling. Cause you're expressing the most ridiculous thing in the world. So wait, what am I? Can't make it, so you're taking home I can't work out if I'm a Nazi terror pedo or a pedo terror Nazi. Don't even lie to me, you like to exaggerate. Serial killer. Then change the rhyme around that can aggravate me. So when you see me come up, am I a pedo terror Nazi? I hope I'm not a pedo terror Nazi. I know that they who think wrong, if they can't do that style that I'm doing, they like fucking bolshy pedo terror Nazi. DJ, if anything you play sound familiar, I'll wait to eat safe plan. So I'm gonna have to diss who broke, you can get a smack for this. I ain't no joke. I think I may have accidentally stumbled across some, like, military secrets, though. Because people have been quite... People of my family and in my entourage, which doesn't exist, but my previous entourage, which were... Everyone was pretty cool up until the summer. I don't really know what the fuck happened. Seems like when I stopped smoking methamphetamine, like, people stopped liking me. Like, it was fucking weird. Before you know it, you're following the fiend, waiting for the punchline to get the meaning. Like before, the moral of my story I'm telling, nobody beats the R, so stop yelling, save it, put it in your pocket for later, cause I'm moving the crowd and be a record fader. No interruptions till the mic is broke. When I'm gone, then you can joke. Since everything is real on the serious tip, and now I can't even be in a fucking good mood anymore without, like, people saying Andrew's being like, oh, that guy's on crystal meth. If I was on crystal meth, I would not look like I was, like, was on MDMA. I did do a little bit of that, dude. But... Like, seriously. Like, what the fuck is this suspicion? And who the fuck hacked into my computer? And how the fuck do I stop it? I mean, this is what happens, though, Larry. I'm determined, though, now that some cunt has done this, I'm not gonna let you rest. I'm gonna fucking keep going. I'm just gonna, when I want to, I'm gonna fucking jizz on Stony Girl. Alex is pretty pissed off because there seems to be some kind of myth that I impregnated someone. Every girl that I've been, like, ever been anywhere close to will tell you. Like, they. See, that's probably why girls hate me right now, because there's some myth that I impregnated someone, and they're like, oh, why was he such a, like, quiet, like, just awkward, withdrawn loner with me when he's, like, locked up some girl and killed the baby? I'm like, makes no fucking sense. Jesus Christ. Really think I knocked someone up? If I knocked someone up, I would have the balls to admit it, okay? And I'm, you know. You may have heard, I've got a track called Kickback. And I told you guys, everything I say, it's true. Now, truth for me, I know I've been to university and I've studied, so I'm probably not allowed to, you know, talk about existentialism and stuff and still be a rapper, but I'd quite like to, you know, like, I mean, like, a kid from the West, for example. A track about a fucking gunslinger. It was a soul singing, gunslinging kid from the West. Those were the original lyrics. You know, it was not fucking Irish. It's not Irish. I'm not Irish. Stop thinking that I'm Irish. Why do you think that I'm Irish? Where the fuck did this idea that I'm Irish come from? Because I like the Irish? I'm not Irish. Not once did I say that I was Irish. Like, that's the most ridiculous thing. These are the things that are like, oh man, this guy says he's Irish. He's not Irish. He's a liar. Like, fuck you. Fuck you, man. Like, Jesus Christ. I'm not a kid from the West. There's more than one West, you fucking idiot. There's West Pass Island. And actually, I probably am a kid from the West, to be honest. From Wales. That's west of here. Everything west of... To be honest, everything west of right here is west. Do you understand that concept? Do you understand the concept of navigation? Like, seriously. And like, what? My song Stop Me, that I wrote about, that's more like to do with tension and stuff, you know, and if I can't write a song, I'm not, there is a site up here, where there is a traveler community, and I've had interactions with them, both positive and negative, but actually mostly positive. This was an occasion where the interaction was not so positive, but I think the point of art is to create a fucking reaction, you know? What the fuck are you doing if you're not creating a reaction? You know, I'm sorry to the traveler community, but I believe that my positive interactions outweigh the fact that I'm pulling in pikies. You know, is that really so wrong? I mean, they call themselves pikies, come on, man. Like, a little bit, sometimes. They do, I think, actually. Travelers know themselves, do what they want. And I'm a traveler too, man. I'm not an Irish traveler, but I fucking travel, man. I've been traveling since I was like, shit, since I was maybe like 3 years old. That's the first time we moved house. 3 years old, moved to some other place in Belgium. And then I moved to like, when I was seven, I moved to west coast of Scotland, where my mum's from, nearabouts. And then down here, which is really cool. I enjoyed being down here. It was great. And I moved to France for a bit. And I moved to Bosnia, slash going to school in Canterbury. So I lived in Bosnia. That was really cool. I fucking love Bosnia. Awesome place. Sarajevo, man. Like, one of my favorite countries in the world. Bosnia. Ja volim Bosnu. Ja volim govoriti bosanski jezik. Dobar jezik. Hvala dobro za sve. Ja volim Bosnu, ja volim Hrvatsku, ja volim Srbiju, sve. Why the fuck can't I love the Balkans? Fuck you, man. And fuck you for thinking that the Balkans is some fucking backwater. Like, we're just like... It's a fucking beautiful place. It's probably the most beautiful place in Europe, I'd say. Like, in terms of people, in terms of, like, history, culture. You know, Bosnia was Ottoman for like 500 years. And then Austro-Hungarian for like 150. And then a whole bunch of other things. You know, and, you know, the Bosniaks were originally Serbs mostly, but they're the ones who converted to Islam. So, I mean, Bosnia, you know, Bosnia is a Muslim country. Just because I lived in a Muslim country, well, majority Muslim, yeah. Republika Srpska, of course. Just because I fucking lived in a Muslim country does not make me a fucking terrorist. You ignorant piece of shit. See, like, that's the thing, man. Like, I'm so next level. But you're flipping on the mids while I'm tripping on my treble. The devil's on the detail, he pray we fail. We not listen cause we powerful, we breathe nails, we feed gales. Got them bullets being cold facts, I tell it straight. Cause you're a mouse and I'm a soul cat. And I don't fold stacks anymore, but it was pretty easy when I got into the swing of things. When you trip a fickle snitch, you find the switch to flip the system. And just fucking ask KRS-One about bitch, you know, like, I mean, that's the thing that... Or just, like, ask anyone, really, from, like, the originating, like, where hip-hop originates, you know? Like, New York or whatever, or, like, you know, like, it's just... Like, a bitch does not necessarily have to mean a woman. I've never fucking beaten anyone up. I even wrote a song about why you should, like, why it's wrong to fucking hit women called Coming Up. It was like an anti-woman beating song. Like, but nobody cared, so I wrote this up. You know, it's about a dude meets a girl who has an abusive boyfriend, and the girl runs off with him. Then the abusive boyfriend, Sancho, comes and he fucking kills him. But then no one gives a fuck. Because it's just like, oh, it's fashion week. Oh, yeah. Blah, blah, blah. It's just someone got killed. It doesn't matter. You know? Like, how the fuck do you breathe? Like, seriously, man, like, this has got to the point where I'm, like, I'm really questioning whether, like, whether people in this world actually, like, are capable of reasoning. Like, do you have the ability to reason? I think you do, but like, why don't you use it? Why do you not use your ability to reason? And you know, like, I think a lot of people out there kind of are using their ability to reason. But it's a fucking idiots out there who are like, nah, he's a fucking pedo terror Nazi. He's a fucking pedo terror Nazi wife beater. Baby murderer. And then, like, at the end of the day, like, you know, it's just people like, you know, I think it's just people who just are so repressed. So just repressed within themselves. They can't really, like, acknowledge, like, other people's expression, like, self-expression, and, like, just be positive about it. You know, like, what's the harm in just being like, oh, that's cool, that makes me think about stuff. Oh, I like that. Rather than, oh my god, sings a song about a dude who runs off with a girl whose boyfriend abuses her, and then the boyfriend kills him. Oh, maybe he's a pedophile. Like, is this the logic that you're working on? Just to be clear, fuck you, Misha, fuck you, Alex, fuck you, Georgia. I'm actually, like, getting more, I'm less on the fuck you, Georgia bandwagon these days. I'm more on the fuck you, Phil bandwagon. Like, so I really think that he's, that guy is actually, like, he's incredibly vindictive, and you wouldn't really believe it, you like, knowing him superficially, but actually, he's a very, very, very vindictive person. So fuck you, Phil. Actually, Georgia, you know, I'd actually like to patch him up, if we can, but that'd be alright. I still want to finish Dear Landlord. To be honest, like, if you don't want me to finish it, then I'm gonna finish it and probably say goodbye to any kind of friendship for you. Because I really want to finish it. Because I need, like, it's fucking hard to write it, though, like, it's painful. I mean, I'm smiling because I'm on, like, some Class A drugs right now, but I'm on, like, MDMA. But it is, it's really fucking painful. And yeah, Priscilla's sister. Fuck you for getting that fucking dude who lives in your house to chase me out with a fucking pipe. Fuck you. You cunt. That's a fucking cunty thing to do. Your sister had work like 2 hours later in the morning. You kicked us both out. Why would you do that? Fuck you, man. I'm not bold just because I rock gold. Rock cameras on the mic. And you know I got soul. Your own fucking sister you take out because she invites some dude back from work. Like, what the fuck was that going on? I don't understand. See, this is all that remains, and I actually haven't really fucking bought any weed in a long time. This is actually from fucking May. honestly, you know, and it's just been keeping me going. I don't really smoke all the time. I don't smoke weed every day. I smoke weed a little bit here and there to get inspired. You know. I had to limit my flatmate to 3 grams of weed a day. I had to limit Phil to 3 grams. Like, fucking ration him to 3 grams of weed a day. I'm not even joking. But that, it was actually 2 grams, but he wanted to go up to 3. I just was like, fuck you, man, no. This is what I'm saying. Like, I bet there's people all over, right? Who are like, yeah, okay, well,
yeah, yeah. I mean, yeah, we called him Danny the Killer in school, but, what's all this about selling weed up in St. Andrew? There's people up in St. Andrew being like,
I know the police.
I don't personally know them, but I know that they don't want to waste their time. Investigating like a student drug dealer, but quite clever. Like, who stopped what he's doing like 6 months ago. Like, a real criminal is fucking go for it. Because if not, and you got more, I'll wait. But don't make me wait too long. Yeah. The dance floor. Fuck. When they put I live and die by my word now. You know what I mean? When it's loud. Like, because I like to move the crowd. I'm going so deep into this ball of paranoia. So I really have no idea who the fuck did this. But it's actually working out pretty good. It's a little bit. I feel like a fucking whore, but I'm just not being paid money. It's like you just want me, like, fucking give me money. Give me money if you want me to haul myself out. All I want to do is write music. I was getting in such a fucking good vein, you know? Alex, she asked me to write a song. She's like, can you write me a song, please, called Absence of Apathy? Absence of Apathy. She was like, can you write a song for me, please, called Absence of Apathy? I was like, but you're not... But, like, you're the most apathetic person I know. Like, so... And I've barely ever seen you. So, like, we'll change to Absence and Apathy. So, like, you're kind of far away. And you're just really fucking apathetic. So I write about Absence and Apathy. And I wrote a few verses about her. Then I wrote a few verses about Georgia. I did, like, when she came back, I was a bit pissed off with her. So I sang it to her and told her it wasn't about her. But it's true, it wasn't really about her. It's not about anyone. A song's like fucking hell, man. Like, a song you don't write. Well, I don't, anyway. I don't sit down with an idea like, okay, today I'm gonna write a song about. I'm gonna write a song about flowers. No. You find a fucking line and you follow that line, you know? Because I like Linton Kwesi Johnson, right? He says, you know, there is no void where noises can collect and be made mute before the rain escapes. You know? And so I had that line in my head, like, a void. There's no void where noises can... So I was like, there's a void where the noise goes. And somewhere in her soul, she doesn't try to fill it because she's scared of being old. Which is, I think she probably is, right? There are boys where the void is. They come and then they go. It basically refers to the fact that she's just a fucking slag. Basically. He just, like, fucks anything that moves, apart from me. Because I don't really want to be with a 17-year-old girl. I mean, I fuck her.
That's fuck up.
Norby Walters is our agent, but right? Karen Lewis is our agent.
Well, I don't want to, like, I don't want to be with our record company. Like,
okay, so who are we rolling with then? We rolling with Rush. Rush Town Management.
Like,
check this out.
And so, yeah, so she tries to fill this, like, emptiness in her heart with just, like, sex. Sometimes something surfaces. Sometimes, you know, she's like, you know, something surfaces. But she puts it down below. Because she likes being so fucking apathetic. I know. She sounds like trouble. She's pretty vicious. I actually had a dream a few years ago. It's quite a sexy dream. I wrote a song about it called Pretty Vicious. And like, man, I'm not writing a song specifically about a person. It's like, when you get the idea in your head, you just fucking run with the idea. And so it's like, it becomes more about like, more story, you know? And you know why you write shitty songs? And I write like songs that are half decent? It's because I'm not fucking trying to, like, I'm not looking at every fucking word being like, okay, this is the next word that has to be here, like, oh, where does it come from, like, oh, what am I trying to say, no, you fucking write it, and then you figure out what it's saying, you know, you get pulled by the words, you don't push them, it just comes out. Hit the studio, cause I'm paid for. And I think any artist, any like songwriter,
you go to your girl's house and
of any kind of half decent caliber will tell you that. You know, they don't, you don't sit. Like, that's why you're fucking frustrated, because you think it's all about like finding, like, starting with a fucking meaning and making a song around that meaning. No, it's not about that at all. It's about extracting beauty through music and verse and lyrics. And so, you know, you get a line and you just follow that line. I have no idea what's gonna happen or what I'm writing about when I start a song. I have no idea. It's just a feeling. That's literally it. And then at the end of the song, I'm like, oh that's pretty cool. Oh. And then sometimes I have lyrics in there, and they're like a little bit, yeah. Maybe that could be interpreted in a kind of weird way. But you know, people will give me the benefit of the doubt because people know me more or less, and they know that I'm not a pedo terror Nazi. But no! No! These cunts! These little fucking cunts! Come and be like, oh, this guy's a pedo-terror Nazi. Fuck you! You're a cunt. You are a cunt of the highest order. Not you. But you... Yeah, I see you. And you know what? Fuck Mikey. Mikey's a cunt. Now, people may have interpreted that I was pretending to be a bare knuckle boxer. Because I said, if he wants a fight, he can meet the scars on my knuckles. Now, I already have scars on my knuckles. Well, I've got a few little scars on my knuckles. They're not from boxing. I was just being a little bit facetious. I was just being a bit cheeky because it was a game we used to play in school. It's a pretty fun game, actually. It's called Knuckles. Put your knuckles down on the desk. You get like a pound coin. You like flick it at the other person's knuckles across the table. And then the first person to give in loses, and then they keep the quid, or you keep the quid, not either. And it's a fun game, you know. Maybe I've got a few scars here and there. I'm not a fucking bare knuckle boxer. You know I'm not a bare knuckle boxer, you fucking idiot. Are you retarded? That's what I'm trying to figure out. Like, I think I might be the only sane person. Like, do you really think I'm a bare knuckle boxer? Fuck it, I'm a bare knuckle boxer, let's do it. Yeah, why not? I'm a pedo terror Nazi. I like boxing. I mean, I've done a bit of boxing in the past. No, never competitively. But
I was actually more into grappling. That was more my thing. But boxing's cool. I like boxing. Gloves are on now. See, like, I haven't really boxed in a long time, but it's all about, like, I'm tired and a little bit, like, wasted, so I can't really box right now, but I like boxing. It's fun. And fuck you for thinking I'm a psycho for liking boxing. Shell, you know, that kind of thing. Cheap. Nah, I can't kick these on. Trousers are too. Yeah. I'm not in the right state to kick, to do a high kick. Or a low kick, because I don't want to kick my laptop, man. Fuck that. Do you understand now? Do you understand why I've been fucking driven into this fucking funk bunker, which is just a prison to me now? The fucking solitary confinement, except... At least in solitary confinement, you don't have your fucking parents coming in being like, oh, can you keep the noise down? I'm thinking, Mom, I want to be a rapper. Well, actually, that's the thing. I never fucking wanted to be a rapper. Fuck you. I never tried being a rapper. People just assumed that I was trying to be a rapper so I don't have to learn to fucking rap. All I did was write music. Now they're like, man, this guy's not really a rapper. I'm like, fuck you! I never said I was a rapper. Now, I can rap like a motherfucker, but I'm not a rapper. Rapping's really not that hard. And it's really fun. That's the thing, they don't tell you. It's not like, it's really fucking fun. Like, it's not just a bunch of people who want to be cool. That's not what music is. Taking all the fucking fun out of my music. So now I'm like, nah, what's the point? What's the point, man? I think I'm just gonna fucking chill here. Maybe I should upload this. Maybe I should... Should I upload the video of me wanking as well? I lost my mind. I hit the point where I was like, you know, because when you're fucking hacking into my computer and like perving on me, just you are right now. You're fucking perving on me. You are.
You're like, man, this guy's voyeuristic. Like, while you fucking sat there with your binoculars on. A voyeuristic fake rapper pedo Nazi wife beater. Terror Nazi wife beater, sorry. And that's the thing, I think I may have accidentally stumbled onto, like, some fucking military secrets. Just by fucking accident. I uploaded a thing. Because this is what's got me paranoid. It's like, why would people be watching me? Why? You know? Is it because I, like, met a kid? And, like, just had a good, like, afternoon? Well, not even a fucking afternoon. It's like, it's half an hour. Just like, oh, sits next to me on the bench. I'm like, oh, yeah. Alright, man. Whatever. Blah, blah, blah. He's like, hey, oh, can I follow you? Blah, blah. I'm like, yeah, alright, fair enough. And there was a children's bookstore. And I was like, oh, man. It's like, because it's fucking closed down. Everything in this town is closed down. Except for the supermarkets. You know, I was like, well, that would be a really cool picture, actually. Like, yeah, let's get him, let's have a picture of this kid who's got this foam thing that he bought for 50p. Who's like, yeah, this is my favourite toy. Like, man, that's tragic. And it's like just outside a children's bookstore. That's got no books in it because no one wants to fucking buy their kids books. But then he keeps following me. And there's like, I found some pretty cool paintings. Like artwork, street artwork. Which I didn't actually know there was much of in Simwon. And he's like, yeah, can I be in the photo? I'm like, yeah, sure, man. He's like, go and take a picture of that pigeon. Oh, yeah, sure, man. Fucking ducks, man. If you ever think that's funny, then I think you really need to, like, examine your sense of humor. Like, man, this guy's a psycho. This guy, like, hates ducks. It's got to the point where I can't even order duck in a restaurant anymore without thinking the fucking, like, KGB are onto me. I'm a little bit wary. I'm a little bit concerned that I may have accidentally stumbled across something fucking massive. With the, you know, the line of Panchia. My dad is like, okay. See, the thing is, I live in a very strange situation in that my dad's got a pretty nice cushy job in Brussels. But I've also got three siblings. And they've also tried their best to put us all through the best possible education they had. So we never actually had any money growing up. Like, everything went into, like, our investment for us. And so maybe that's why I've turned out to someone who thinks about shit. You know? While you're just sat there with your fucking binoculars on. Man, this guy's a stalker. This guy's a stalker. Look, I can see him. He's a stalker. You've taken all the fun out of my music. And the music, I did. Most of the stuff that I've been, like, uploading recently is, like, old songs, which I did in a very fucking low and lonely point in my life. Shit was all, like, crazy and fucked up. And so, yeah, it is pretty dark, you know? But what the fuck is wrong with that? There's nothing wrong with expressing how you feel through music. In fact, I thought that was the whole point of music. Do I still feel that way? Not really. I mean, the songs I've written, tracks I've written recently, like, I'm not Jamaican. I mean, I figured I'd call it that because, like, you just don't know what the fuck. Like, I've learned that through music, like, people will always make the worst possible assumption when you're creative. They will always make the worst possible assumption. And so, like, you know what? I'm not Jamaican. But maybe they'll think, maybe if I write a song, where they use a bit of Creole here and there, to promote sort of Afro-Caribbean, or not even Afro-Caribbean, just Caribbean culture, because it's not just Afro-Caribbean. There's so many Caribbeans. Fucking Irish were out, slave workers in the sugar plantations. You know, you get white Jamaicans, you get black Jamaicans, you get Indian Jamaicans. You know, like, it's the new world. Everyone's from everywhere. But then I was like, ah, you know what? You know, like, if I write this song, use a bit of, like, a little bit of patois, then people might be like, oh man, this guy's so fake. This guy's so fake. He's not Jamaican. He's not Caribbean. Fuck you, man. Oh yeah, the military secrets. So basically, my dad told me a story about this dude called the Lion of Panjshir, right? And I thought it was just a funny story. A little bit un-PC, but like, we don't want to live in a world of political correctness where everything's censored and like, you're not allowed to make jokes about like the French or, you know, or fucking people of Burundi or whatever, or like, you know, the Alaskans or whoever. I don't know who I've potentially insulted just through like having a stab at humor. Oh shit, it says stab? You must be a fucking psycho. You must be out to like stab people. So these secrets, right? So, Lion of Panjshir, blah blah blah. But there was this dude called Ahmed Ben Assad, I think. Who actually was the Lion of Panjshir. That was his name, the Lion of Panjshir. And he was assassinated 2 days before 9/11. You know, I'm obviously not the only person to know this. That goes without saying. But I've been really fucking looking for reasons why people are spying on me. You know, why? Like, and why no one's admitting it? But you know what? It's happened, so I'm just gonna roll with it. At first, I was extremely, I became extremely paranoid, like, and extremely withdrawn, because like, shit, now I don't know who, if people are watching or how they're watching or whatever, blah 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 blah. So I'm looking for reasons, like, maybe it's the pedo police. Maybe, like, because I fucking had a day out with this kid. It was a fucking afternoon, whatever. Not even afternoon, like, an hour. Just met this kid. Oh, hey there, little Rusty. Yeah, sure, yeah. You can play for CSK Moscow when you want. Like, when you're older. Just work on it. Just do it, man. Hey, like, here's a kid. Blah, blah, blah. Oh, he's a pedo. He's a pedo. Let's call the police. Or else, hold on. Well, Alex, because I was friends with a teenage girl who didn't even want to fuck me. Fuck you. Oh no, he raped a 14-year-old and killed a baby. Oh. So then, but the more I look at it, like, I mean, obviously those two are completely and utterly fucking mind-bogglingly ridiculous. So then I'm starting to think, well, who the fuck could it be? Could it be the fucking GCHQ? You know, like, what? Like, my dad works for... He worked for NATO. Well, he works for NATO, and he worked in... He was like, he was in Iraq. You know, he spent most of my teenage years off in the Middle East. You know, like doing God knows what. And you know, he says, you know, he signed all these secret pacts or whatever, signed all these secrecy agreements. And you know, and it got me thinking, like, well, we're talking about the line of Pangaea, like quite, you know, a few. You know, just like casually between me and my siblings when, you know, we were having a good time. We're like, oh, did you hear about the Lion of Pangaea? I just chucked in a grenade and blah, blah, blah. And so I thought it was a pretty funny story, but with a pretty awesome moral. Like, the fucking cool message in that story. And so I related it. And then I got reading, and I was like, oh, actually, this dude's totally real. And he was assassinated just 2 days before 9/11. Who would benefit from that? Who would benefit from the guy who rallied the disparate tribes of Afghanistan against the Soviets and repelled them, and rallied the disparate tribes of Afghanistan against the Taliban as well? Because the Taliban, they're not... Afghanistan is not the fucking Taliban. Taliban are a small group of crazy people who like radicalize the people that we bomb. You know, that's what happens. And who benefits from that? Who benefits from having a fucking war over there? Well, the bomb companies, obviously. Like, that goes without saying. That's like the most simple thing. Like, but, you know, like, and then, like, you know what? Maybe they are. Because we live in this fucking era. We live in this era. We're just, like, talking about Afghanistan and being a fan of the Barbed Wire Dolls with a lead singer called ISIS Queen, who predates ISIS, who fucking predates the Islamic State. ISIS is an Egyptian goddess. Oh, and what else did I do? Oh yeah, I wrote a song called When the Bombs Come, which I've been quite... I don't really want to, like, upload it. Well, I do want to upload it, but now it's like... Like, do I really want to go to Guantanamo? I don't want to go to Guantanamo. But that's the era that we live in, because people can fucking wiretap you for just, like... You know, that's three things. That's three things that say, like, maybe I'm a terrorist. Oh, he's lived in a Muslim country. Oh, he's got a beard now. Oh, he's got a beard. How did he get that beard? Guys, this beard is growing. He must have something behind the beard. He likes ISIS Queen. He likes the Barbed Wire Dolls. He wrote a song inspired by a Romeo and Juliet-esque story of star-crossed lovers who are on two sides of an opposing conflict, or when the bombs come. Where, in keeping with the Greek classical tradition, you know, it has a catastrophe. Catastrophe, you know, is the part where the hero dies. And so, you know, that's a tragedy. That is a tragedy. The person dies in a tragedy. There's either a comedy or a tragedy. I tend to write tragedies. You know, Shakespeare wrote a bunch of tragedies, and I don't really think his comedies are all that great. You know, but you don't be like, oh, Shakespeare, maybe he was a Nazi terrorpedo. Maybe Shakespeare didn't write his stuff at all. Maybe he killed someone and just took all the credit. Yeah. If I had killed someone, or just like, if I had stolen this from someone, don't you think they would have done something with the music? And so that's what's so depressing and frustrating and just demotivating. It's the same fucking people who've been like, oh, Arthur, you're shit at music, Arthur, you're shit at music, Arthur, you're shit at music, all my life, we're now like, oh, he's always been shit at music. How come he's writing songs now? Maybe he raped a 14-year-old. Like, you're a fucking idiot. Do you understand how much of an idiot you are? I don't think you even understand that. This blows my mind. Did I mention that I had a brief, I had a fairly brief love affair with methamphetamine? I love methamphetamine. I love that drug. It's just the most, like, it's like Adderall, basically. You know, it's speed, but like Adderall is speed that they market you, they give you, you know, because they can make money off giving speed to people, you know, selling it to them. And the prison industry can make, well, not here, maybe, I don't know how it's run here, but in America, the prison industry is for profit, and they make a lot of shit. They make a lot of military equipment. It's a military-industrial complex. So, yeah, methamphetamine. And so I was, like, briefly, like, you know, towards the end of the spring, I was really getting, like, heavy on the pipe. Where's my pipe still here? Where's it gone? Yeah. Oh, here it is. Yeah. Here we go. Trust the old pipe. So, I was getting, like... Sadly, all the ice is gone. But, yeah, so I was up in a very conservative university town, full of Americans for some reason in Scotland, and they're all Republican. They're all from Connecticut, and none of them have any experience at all with people who suffer from real addiction, really, apart from like in their sort of upper class, like, bloody pass the brandy, mate, like, let's get sloshed, or like, you know, I mean, alcoholism doesn't depend on like class or money or anything like that, but I don't think anyone up there that I met has known people with real addictions. I've known a few people with like real absolutely destructive addictions, and so I got a reputation as being some kind of a crackhead junkie because I was dabbling in the speed, which, come on guys, at Anarchy Camp there's going to be a methamphetamine symposium, so let's go there. So I got a reputation of being a fucking crackhead junkie, and when my mind was still like free to tweet whatever I wanted without being persecuted for it, I sort of commented on this. I was like, you know what? Like, my reputation's done here. Like, it was stupid of me because Twitter is more than St. Andrews. Actually, it's true. It's bigger than St. Andrews. That's what I liked about it. That's what I liked about Twitter in the first place, is because I could get my ideas out without being judged by my peer group, really. But then they found it. Everyone found it eventually. No, everyone denies it. My family deny it while just, like, making jokes about shit that I've done on Twitter all the time. And, you know, it's pretty fucked up, I think. You know, just be like, yeah, I know you've got Twitter. Like, what's wrong with that? Twitter's really fun when you get into it. It's addictive. It's like, then when people who can't really think for themselves read it and get jealous, they're like, oh, maybe he's a terrorist. Yeah. So, with that, I bid you adieu. I'll probably post this to YouTube. So if anyone's got any questions or anything like that, just fucking ask me, please. Just ask me. Because I don't want to have to go through any of this shit anymore. Like, oh yeah, but the other thing was, yeah, so I got this reputation of being a crackhead junkie up in St. Andrews. And then, like, you know, I'm meeting people now, again, who don't have yachts and don't have private aeroplanes, like many people up in St. Andrews do. And so it's kind of like I'm stuck between this world of, like, they think I'm being fake by trying to pretend that I'm some kind of, like, that it's cool to be a drug addict or la la la, while people in St. Andrews think that I'm a fucking crackhead junkie. There's no middle ground. Like, you know, and you wonder why I drink.